Shelly went to show, ladies and gentlemen. I see you, brother. I see you. So, J.D. Vance's mom, I think her name is Bev. If you've never read the book or seen a movie, Hillbilly Elegy, it's on Netflix. I watched it again last night. It's a great movie. I saw it when it first came on Netflix because I read the book and I was so excited when they made a movie about it. Ron Howard directed it. And it's J.D. Vance's life, Hillbilly Elegy. Read it or watch it. Read it, because if you read it, you get an idea of his policy and where he comes from. But the movie's good, too. But let me tell you this, my friends. She's going to be in Trump's box. This is a woman that struggled her whole life with addiction. Her son was raised by his grandmother, Meemaw. That's what he called her. We all have Meemaws in our life. Moms, Meemaws, grandmothers, mothers, aunts, women in our life who believe in us. For me, it was my mom. But for him, his mom had addiction problems. But she's been clean. And now she gets to see her son give a speech introduced by his wife. And then he gives a speech as a vice presidential candidate at under 40 years old. What a proud moment for her. She cleaned her life up. She straightened out her life. And now she gets to sit next to a former president and watch her son as he is nominated, as a candidate for vice president of the United States. I tell that because it's so powerful. It gives me chills. Every single one of us, maybe you don't, I'm generalizing, but a lot of us, I'll say, have family members who have addiction issues. This should give us hope for them. It should give us hope for them. That as long as you draw breath, all things can come out right. As long as you wake up in the morning, everything can be all right. She made a decision some years ago not to pick up anymore. Now, that had nothing to do with her son's rise, but still, she's able to watch her son from the Republican National Convention sitting next to the former president of the United States while her son gives a speech while accepting the nomination as the vice presidential pick. Yeah. God is good, ladies and gentlemen, all the time. God is good. This should give many of us hope for our family members, our friends, our loved ones who may be going through stuff, that as long as you draw breath, things can and will be better. For some of us, we can do all things through Christ. For some of us, God is good. For others of us, Allah bless us, peace be upon him. No matter what your faith tradition, no matter what it is, God has you. God has you. And she's a testament to God having her and her family. Good for her. Good for her. Good for her. It's good for her. I want to tear up a little bit, you know? No, for real. I really do. This woman gets to see her son after spending all those years in her own depression, in her own black world, in her own blackness. She comes out of it and look at the sunshine. Look how bright the sunshine is for her. That woman is going to be beaming with pride. With pride. She's going to be thinking about Meemaw. And without Meemaw, he's not there. She's going to be thinking about the family and all the people that stepped into JD's life because she wasn't there. But she cleaned her act up, and now she's there to take in the sunshine radiating from her son. It's powerful, man. It is powerful. And it's not like she disappeared and she's just coming back now. She's been there. He was helping her. In the movie, in the book, he talks about it. In the movie, they dramatize it by he's getting ready to do a big interview to get into Yale Law School, and he's got to drive to put her into rehab. But that's just the dramatization of the fact that he was there. He didn't abandon his mom. Through her troubles, he didn't abandon his mom. Let me tell you, man. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. You got to be a real hater to not feel that. I'm sorry. Just to get chills. Get chills. All right, let me bounce back. So, Anthony Anderson, did we find that clip? We got that. So Anthony Anderson is a comedian. He's filling in for one of these late night shows. I don't know which one it is. The Seth guy. I don't know which one it is. He's filling in for one of these late night shows. And this is him talking about Tim Scott. But this is also the Democrats talking about toning down the rhetoric. By the way, before we play that, we're going to midnight tonight. If you're just joining us, we will be covering J.D. Vance's wife, her speech introducing J.D. Vance. And then we'll play both speeches in their entirety, and then we'll come back on the air and talk about it. So just keep it locked here. There's no reason to go anyplace else. 404-872-0750. 1-800-WSB-TALK. But this is Anthony Anderson talking about Tim Scott. Listen to this disgusting, disgusting, crazy joke, if you will. And I'm doing air quotes.
Now, the other major league event this week is the Republican National Convention, also known as the White People's Choice Awards. You know, last night was when the delegates officially nominated Trump, which means there was a lot of ass kissing on display. But no one kissed more ass than the senator from South Carolina, Tim Scott.
On Saturday, the devil came to Pennsylvania holding a rifle, but an American lion got back up on his feet and he roared! Oh yeah! He roared!
Tim, Trump already picked his running mate. You don't have to do this, bro. You know, that wasn't even the most ridiculous thing Tim Scott said. This was.
I know this is going to offend the liberal elites. Every time I say it, it offends them. But let me say it one more time. America is not a racist country.
Attention, large crowd of white people. America is not a racist country. Thanks, Uncle Tim or Tom, whichever you go by.
President Biden spoke today in Las Vegas.
Did you hear that? The fascinating thing about that is the joke. There was a funny joke there. Hey, Tim, he already picked J.D. Vance, right? That's funny. That's funny. That I give you that. That's a good one. But the rest of it. Hey, group of white people, America's not a racist country. Dude, you're kind of not a real funny comedian guest hosting a comedy night, late night comedy show to Americans. Like, literally, you're an African-American guy on the stage talking to a bunch of white folks in the audience saying, oh, yeah, America's still racist. That's why I'm here guest hosting. Very prominent late night talk show. That's how racist the country is. It's just baffling to me. But then to hit him with the Uncle Tim, oh, I mean Tom. Like, why? Why aren't you and Uncle Tom for standing in front of a group of white people and telling bad jokes? Why aren't you a step and fetch it too? Every character you play, with the exception of Blackish, every character you played in the movie was always just a goofy fat guy. Why aren't you a step and fetch it? Why can't I call you an Uncle Tom? Why can't I call you Steven? Why can't I call you just as Mr. Bojangles? Why not? Because it wouldn't be right for me to do that. It wouldn't be appropriate for me to do that. It wouldn't be correct for me to do that. But it's okay for you to get up in front of a bunch of white liberals and call another black man because you disagree with his politics, Uncle Tom? Are you mad, sir? Seriously, are you mad? You think that's cool? You weren't at the Apollo. You weren't at the NAACP meeting. I could get it there. But you're at a late night, Seth Meyers, whatever it is, in front of a massive majority white liberal audience. And you called another black man to those white folks in that audience and Uncle Tom. And you thought that was cool. Man, I tell you, man. It's people who would do anything for the masters. Oh, I'm sorry, Shelley. I shouldn't have said that. I'll be right back.